today?
Today we're going to be making Cakepops for the first time with you guys.
I've never made Cakepops. None of us have ever made Cakepops. So, since COVID, we haven't been to any parties, so I am so excited to make these.
Let's stop talking and get started.
Now that's much better.
A.
V.
E.
Okay, so the first step of making cake pop is to have a ready-made cake. And you can make any type of cake you want, red velvet, chocolate, or vanilla. So as you can see, we are using vanilla cake today. So since you can see it's a little burnt on the ends, and that's fine. The point of that is so you can cut the edges off, and be careful when you're using a knife. So you're just gonna cut it, you don't wanna cut too much of the cake off. So just be careful when you cut it. It should come off pretty easy.
We call a professional baker.
Oh.
It's just like a square shape.
Yeah. So you can use also any type of pan you want. It doesn't have to be a circle cake pan because you're going to be crumbling it at the end. So it doesn't really matter.
Just the master chef's advice.
Yeah, master chef and my knife's a master chef because I am a master chef.
Oh, nice.
I think this cake's gonna be really good when you crumble it and everything. Mm-hmm. It looks so good.
Let me get a plate.
Hey.
Always have a small plate or a big plate?
Any size plate is fine.
Okay, small plate.
Okay, thank you, Ethan. That was very helpful. I'm just going to put these on here so it doesn't stir me doing that. And our last... Okay, that did. That was easy. So now that we've cut up all of, I guess, the ends that are kind of harder, we have to cut it into four. So don't try your best not to touch it that much.
Mathematical way for
one...
Force. What is that supposed to mean?
What?
Like a snake.
Yep. Four. And you can also cut off the top if you absolutely want to be soft, which is what I'm gonna do. And it's also much easier if you do it now, because if you do it you don't want to have crunchy parts in your cake, and that's not fun at all.
Yeah.
So just you want to have as much of the soft pieces as you can. Oh. That's okay. And you're going to have a mess, so that's normal. So we've got our first cake slice in here, and it looks like this. It looks really good. And now you're going to do that with all four of your slices. And you can go in and cut off wherever you feel like you need to. It doesn't just have to be these parts. But that's what we're going to do.
Two. Okay. This one looks bigger.
And so it's okay if you have any fail, because this is our first time making it. I've never, ever made cake pops before. So, yeah, I'm just doing this, I've watched a couple of videos, but I'm trying my best to do it on my own. Okay, so now it's Ethan's and Ethan's turn to do something. So we've all washed our hands. Make sure you wash your hands for this step, because you want to have good hygiene when you do this step, because you're going to take your hands and crumble in. And if we're all going to be touching it, it's not that good if you have dirty hands. So first up, we're going to have Ethan go in and just crumble this.
Just crumble it?
Don't go like this. Just try your best not to do it.
Just break it apart?
Yeah. This looks crumbling. This is not that hard to crumble. It's kind of fun. It's because you get to get messy. And I never crumbled a cake before.
He likes to get messy.
Yeah, as you can see on my apron.
I don't like messy. Maybe that's why she likes slime.
Yeah, I make slime. Then nobody else likes
it. I'm not good at
that's why her desk, her desk in her room has slime.
saying SpongeBob SquarePants so much. I don't know. I don't want to.
I like SpongeBob.
But this is how it looks, and I'm pretty
now happy. That we've had our perfectly crumbled cake, we're going to be using our buttercream frosting or any frosting you want to make it more thick and like kind of like a Play-Doh texture. So you want to add like a tablespoon, doesn't have to be exact, or you can just put it until you get the texture you want. So Ahan's gonna add that in, okay? Get 1 tablespoon of that.
What the tablespoon?
First stir it for a little stir. Wait, we're gonna stir it. Stir it, stir it. No, stir it. Mix it.
I like when you buy like a Nutella or like a peanut butter or something like that, and then you just stir it for the first time.
It kind of looks like Nutella except white.
Oh,
white Nutella.
Okay, add that in.
Oh, no, don't get it. You want me to put it? Just plug it.
Yeah.
Ding, 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 ding.
We can make a song out of that.
So it's okay. We wash your hands so you can go in with your hands. But if not, you do not want to be using your dirty hands. So we're done with this. We might need it, but we're going to leave it at the side for now. Now, yeah. It's also another time that we're going to have to go in with our hands. So we washed our hands. And I'm going to go in first with it. So, yeah, so we got our crumble cake and our... Oh, my God, this is actually, like, really sticky. So you have... I don't know...
But how come you can handle slime then?
Because it's...
It's less stickier because you have, like, activator or something.
Yep.
Okay. Okay, you can just put a whole bottle of
no,
activator.
Never drink activator. That can kill you.
Can it?
Yep. So this is kind of, as you can see, it's like starting to form more like into balls before it was just falling apart. So that's a good sign.
Play-Doh.
So don't Play-Doh. Think like another thing that you might make a mistake on is you might add more and more because it's not forming, but you have to work on it for a little bit and then you'll see even if you add a little bit and it'll come more. So yeah.
Yeah, it's like coming together like how you did it.
Yep.
Good.
You don't want it to be like in a ball like when
Perfect.
You make cookies or whatever. You want it to be still like this, but like formable. Okay, so
formable.
I can't touch it. So how about Ehan? Ehan, give that to Anna now. The frosting.
The frosting flakes.
Yep. Ehan's gonna add it in now, cause we it seems
flakes.
Like we need a bit more. Hold it. I'm
I
not
said
gonna.
Those touch. Are frosted flakes.
Hold it.
I'm gonna lie.
Okay, now take it. And I love buttercream frosting just by itself. So it tastes so good.
So just like this much.
Okay. Yep. Okay.
Yep. I just want to put that all in my mouth.
Okay, I think that's good. That's good enough. Okay.
You know, guys, Close off it. Camera, when I was, you know those crust stuff of the cake? I was eating it and it actually tastes really good.
Okay, Ehan, how about you go get a plate for that? Because you also don't want to make a mess, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Should I bring a small plate like I did before?
Yes, bring a small plate. We don't need a big plate for this.
Okay.
It's actually coming. You wanted a Play-Doh, so if you guys know how Play-Doh feels, then you'll know how the right texture of this will feel.
That there?
I know what Play-Doh feels like. Hard.
Yep. You've played
it a lot. Not that hard.
It's not that hard. You're like...
In making this, you will need a lot. Okay, I'm gonna put this here.
That's a lot.
That's yummy.
It's really yummy. Yummy in my tummy. Okay, now I feel it now. Look at my hand. I look like a cake monster with my hands.
Then you
have
to
like
put
in
on
an
your
animal
face,
they had something
your
called
ears,
a cookie monster.
Your hair.
I'm a cake monster. Yep.
Your shirt, your pants.
Yeah, I'm gonna be really messy.
I'm not gonna say the rest.
Yeah, I think
it's
now
gonna
it's
be weird.
So look at this, you guys. Now a little bit of an inside shot. It's like staying in a ball, right? So we're gonna form it, and we'll see you guys right when we're done forming it into ball. So I'm gonna show you guys just how it looks a little. I lied. Okay. So you want it to be like about this size because it might get a little bigger.
So just add a little bit more.
Do you use like popsicle sticks to stick it on or something?
You're gonna use lollipop sticks, and that's what we're gonna show you after this. Okay.
I think I saw it.
So this is how one of the balls look like. Just like that. And that's how we're gonna make for all of our cake pops. So we'll see you when we're done. All right, guys, we formed all of our cake pop balls, and they should look a little something like this. You want it to be like pretty smooth. It's okay, there's like little lumps everywhere, just not chunky parts. So we've done it pretty well. Now the next step is to get your lollipop sticks right here and some Wilton candy melts or any, I guess, chocolate, but I think these work the best. And you're gonna melt them in the microwave or on your stove for 30 second intervals, just to make sure that you don't burn it. Yeah, intervals kind of just like to check in on it so you don't burn, because then you're gonna ruin your good chocolate that you bought. So that's what we're gonna go do now. So yeah, we're gonna go take this into the microwave. So I'm gonna put it in like this. Make sure the container is microwavable safe. Because plastic is not good for microwavable things. You'll blow your ass on. So I'm gonna put it in for 25 seconds actually, because I'm kind of scared. Just wait, now it's gonna chill here. Okay, you take it out. Maybe it'll be hot to hold it from the kind of the top. Don't drop it. It's not melted at all.
Maybe
We should put it in definitely.
Put it for four hours.
I'll put it for a minute.
Nope. Don't do what I just said. Don't put it for 4 hours.
Now we'll wait another minute.
No, close the door.
Close the door.
I'm really happy with how these look though. But before you do that, you could just take a lollipop stick and just put it in one of your balls just to test them, see if they break, and ours are clearly fine. So that's just something that you could do just to test it. So yeah. Mm-hmm. Wait.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14.
14. So basically for the size cake that we made, you can make 14, I guess, depending on the size, but 15 sounds more better, so I'll say 15. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and it also depends on the size you make them. So this is the size of ours.
Oh, that's a big one.
80,
really big one.
15, 14.
I'm sorry, 15, I don't want to burn it.
11, 10, 9.
I have to take it out, okay? Yeah, that's melting all right.
Okay, wow.
I'm gonna come and show you guys. It looks like it's melting. So I'm gonna stir it like this. It might be melted already, but I'm just gonna keep mixing.
Is that supposed to be icing? That could be easier. If you're making pink icing, take this, melt it, you have your icing.
So I'm gonna
pink chocolate icing.
Yep. So I'm gonna put this in for another like maybe 10-15 seconds because still a little slow. You know. Oh, 5 seconds. I guess I'll just leave it in just and then put it. So I guess you could put it in for about a minute and like 10 seconds. 5 seconds is not gonna do anything. That's okay.
For 105 seconds.
105 seconds is gonna burn our chocolate. I don't know why they call these candy melts when it's chocolate. Now our candy melts, I guess, are melted, and what we're gonna do with this is we are going to take our popsicle sticks that I showed you
before,
right
sticks.
Here, and we're going to dip it in like this. So just swirl it around a little. You want to get nice and warm.
And then
make sure
you
the
just
in.
Go like
so
that.
Take that much about that much, right?
That's a lot.
Yep, it is. And then you're gonna just
put it in.
Stick it right in there.
Oh wow!
That was exactly how the video that we watched is.
And this one is kind of breaking, so I might fix that one in later.
Okay, so
swirl it, swirl, 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 swirl.
Wait, so are we just gonna put this like plain? Are we just gonna put around it plain?
Nope, we're going to be coating this with another layer of these.
Okay.
So this is gonna be covered in candy melts. That's what K-pops are, because it's basically like icing, but it's chocolate. Hey, do you wanna try this one?
Okay.
Okay, so you're gonna take it, and you're gonna put it in halfway. So you can, like, after we're done all of our cake pops and the sticks, we'll show you guys the next step.
You can make like art with this.
All right, Ethan, and we finished all of our cake pops and they look pretty good, right? So what's the next step?
The next step is to put these cake pops in the fridge for an hour, or if you have space in the freezer, you can put it for about 30 minutes.
All right, so now let's go do that.
Can you open the fridge for me?
Okay, the fridge.
Because I'm walking backwards.
Okay, we're gonna add it in.
Slime.
Now that all of the cake pops have been in the fridge for one whole hour, it's time to decorate them. So the first step is to get your candy melts. So from the second step, we still have our candy melt, so we're just gonna reuse it so we don't waste it. And we're gonna use a bit more of these because we have decorated all of these. We're gonna transfer it, but we're just gonna...
That is a lot, Mama.
Okay. Stop. I think that should be enough. I don't know.
I think that's a little bit more than enough, you know.
It's okay. You can reuse these. So I'm going to put this in the microwave for 1 minute.
Okay. So maybe since you added more, for like 1.5 minutes, maybe.
But I want to burn it. Okay. 105.
No. We have to make sure that we're checking on it just so we don't burn it. That's why you put it in for a little bit at a time. But I'm really excited. I've never made cake pops, and I think it's looking how it's supposed to look. It looks so good.
One of them have a crack, I think. Yeah, this one has a big.
Yep, they look so good. I really like how all of them look. And the blue also adds like a nice color, so there's like different colors. I really like it.
I don't know how Starbucks people make it like exactly like a circle.
They use like a professional like thing, but you can do it at home like this.
I think it looks like machines or something.
I don't think they have machines at Starbucks, but that's, I didn't know Starbucks had cake pops, but yeah, they do. And we have lots of different items. You can use these sprinkles to decorate too, so it'll make it look nicer. Okay. Okay.
Okay, that's definitely melted. I'm gonna do it right here. So I don't think these other ones that you put are melted. You gotta give it a nice stir first. Does anybody else want to stir? I can stir. Okay, I'm gonna stir it over. Okay, next one.
Oh, it looks kind of weird.
Yeah, I think we need a melted. We do, but if you mix it more, then it'll be like the already melted chocolate will like help the other chocolate melt. Okay, so I put this here.
Mr. Chef.
But why are we making more?
Mr. Chef.
Put
it in the microwave again? Because it's not melted enough, so we have to make sure that it's smooth.
Like, why do we need more of the ice?
So we can coat it.
Can I mix it? Yep, you can mix it. Can I just see? Come to this. Okay, yep, it's hot. Can I just see? Yeah, you can see them. I wasn't even trying. Look.
mix it before it hardens.
Do you want me to mix it?
Nah.
Okay. Wow. I actually feel like we're gonna need more.
I don't know why, but I think this
I think this is enough because, like,
okay, so this chocolate is melted fully now, but to make it even more smoother, because we don't want it to be like chunky still, we're gonna add a little bit of vegetable oil. So we're gonna we're not gonna add it yet. We're gonna first put our chocolate into our glass here.
Oh, wow.
See how it's kind of chunky right now? When we add the vegetable oil, it will make it all smooth. So you can use vegetable oil, coconut oil.
Ah, be careful. It's
I'll be careful.
Don't make this just go crazy. Don't make a mess.
Hey, that looks like a strawberry ice cream.
Yes.
Now it's time to add our vegetable
cream.
It
kind of looks like in the smoothie challenge.
Oh yeah, smoothie challenge. Make sure you
watch that. And none of us won. It's hard. Mine was probably the gross one.
Yep. Make sure you go check out that video.
I only have one good one, which is honey.
Okay.
It's not that.
Now, let's stop talking. Take our cake pops and dip them in. So how this works is, you want to make sure that you like coat it well, but don't make it like stick, because what I did was just wrong because I just ruined it. But don't worry, you're gonna have. All right, fun fact. I'm right now just trying to get to know how to do it, and I think I'm pretty good at getting to coat it. Before, I didn't really know because it was kind of hard. So yeah, it's kind of hard. It's really hard to like put it in with it.
Ooh, looks scary.
Yeah, it's messy. It's really messy, but
it looks very scary. Can I try?
I think I don't really want to do it, but I want to do it because like your hand gets really messy.
So I found why like it was coming off. You shouldn't like put it in too much, but like you could like you have to be careful when you do it. So that's what I'm doing. And you have to like let the extra come off of it. That's what I'm doing right now. So it's like looking like this. You don't want to have like dripping, so that's why we're just putting it, letting the excess drip off inside so they don't waste it. It's looking really good. I really like how it is. And I think it will taste really good as well. Okay, so now that we've coated it all like fully, we are going to take our sprinkles that we have here and just go like this.
We're gonna use our sprinkles.
Yep, and we're gonna decorate them like that.
Looks like a jewel.
And once you're done, you have to make it, let it dry.
Now you have to do the hardest part. Like the hardest part of this is probably putting it in.
I think the hardest part is dipping it.
Can I try now? Okay, you could try. You have to be really careful though. Okay. Please be careful. Don't spin it. Just go like that. I said don't spin it. Okay, wait. Okay, that's good. Now just let it like go like this, just so like the drips can come out.
And don't drop it.
Me. My hand hurt forever. Don't spin too much. So it's looking good. Okay. Now it's time for the sprinkles. So take some of the sprinkles.
Yeah. If you have the flash, would have done it.
That's what I said. Get the sprinkles and put it on the top. Like don't put it on the side, but like yeah. Oh, I did. Okay. Okay, that looks good.
Right there.
Oh my god. Okay.
So hard.
Wow. Okay. And you also want to make sure you have something like this so if it drips, it can drip into the container.
I don't want to try.
You don't want to try?
It looks scary. Can you do it with me?
Okay. Just dip it in, dip it back out.
Master Chef.
Don't spin it that much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, it's scary. You want to like get it? Okay, that looks way better than mine.
This is kind of warm.
Yeah, because it is warm. We just heated up the chocolate.
Well, not
candy melts. Okay, can you hold that? Can you hold that right there?
Okay.
Okay, hold it like underneath that, and I'm gonna get.
Sure thing.
Sure thing.
Okay, now I'm gonna take the
sprinkles and just
sprinkle it on.
Oh yeah.
This is why I kept it under the thing, because it's probably gonna come. And if you.
What if you just put the sprinkles in there and then you just put it?
I don't know. Maybe.
You know, that'd actually be better.
And then they go all around while you're
putting. It will get, like, it might change the color, or like they're really colored.
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
Well, I don't like this feeling.
Way too bad.
Okay.
My hand being.
I'm very excited to eat it.
Okay. This is so hard. I don't know if you can see the struggle I'm going through. Next one. Okay, you guys. I think we have a couple more to do, so we're gonna do that off camera, and we'll see you guys when we're done all of them.
Now we're gonna test how the cake puffs taste, because we haven't tasted them yet.
I'm so excited, because we worked really hard on these. Okay, so we're gonna have one cake pop each, okay?
Be careful.
Oh my god! Let's have a 3-second countdown, okay, Ehan?
3, 2, 1.
Yummy!
That's really good.
You can mostly taste the icing.
I really like how this tastes.
Yeah.
I definitely recommend you guys taste this recipe and make it, because I have never tasted cake pop this good, and it tastes really, really good.
Okay, now let's wrap the video.
Make sure to like, subscribe, and share.
A
B
E
FunFamAve.